Hare Krishna. So we discussed first five verses where invocation prayers, audience is appreciated or acknowledged, and spiritual master offered obeisances. Now we are dealing with chapter 2, section 2. And in this section 2, it is 6 till 29, which is the answer to the first two questions. What is the ultimate and absolute good for all people at all time to come? And what is the essence of all scriptures by which the self can be satisfied? Now, if these two questions have to be answered, these are answered in different categories. This answer can be organized in different ways. Now, first thing is, all the Vedic processes, the whole Vedic science, all the Vedic scriptures offer us four goals, which is called as four purusharthas: dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. So first I will present it roughly here. There are four goals: dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. Now we are sure by this time all the students are expected to know what this means. Dharma means all the religious processes. Artha, why we follow all the religion rules? So that there is economic development. So there is religion, economic development, economic development, and then we have sense gratification, and then we have liberation. So one can fulfill all this. One follows the religious processes, the Vedic processes, so that one can develop and fulfill his needs, and by which one can have sense gratification, all his sense desires can be fulfilled. And when one is frustrated of this, or one is done with this category, then one can search for liberation from this world, liberation from cycle of birth and death. These four are offered. Now, as we already discussed in 1.1.2 Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 1, Text 2, that Bhagavatam rejects these four. Why Bhagavatam rejects these four? Because they are all selfishly motivated. Even liberation, I want to be liberated. I want to get rid of all the material encumbrances, all the miseries, all the entanglement. So Srimad Bhagavatam rejects these four. Srimad Bhagavatam is teaching a religion. So this is called as cheating religion, because there is a selfish motive. But here the highest religion is being taught, which is meant for those who are fully pure in heart. The religion which teaches love of Supreme Lord, Supreme Godhead. Just loving service, which is not based on any selfish agendas or motives. Just loving service for the pleasure of the object of love. Now that is being offered in Srimad Bhagavatam. And because Srimad Bhagavatam is offering that highest dharma, and Srimad Bhagavatam is not offering a dharma which is promoting any of this stuff, any of these goals, Srimad Bhagavatam is offering highest dharma. So because Srimad Bhagavatam is offering the highest dharma, therefore, what is important is, the first thing Suta Goswami does is he compares highest dharma with respect to dharma, artha, kama, and moksha, or a mundane religion. It compares this highest dharma and glorifies the position of this highest dharma. And by glorifying this highest dharma, which promotes selfless loving service unto the Supreme Lord, while saying that, Suta Goswami answers the first question, which was, what is the ultimate and absolute good? And by establishing that this highest dharma is the ultimate and absolute good. And in fact, this is the essence of all scriptures. So let us see how that part is established. Hare Krishna.